Hi, I'm Nat Bartsch, and this is Katie Yap. And before we begin, I'd like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we are performing tonight, the Wurundjeri people of the Kulin Nation, and pay our respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging. Thank you all also very much for coming. It's so special to be playing a show. This is my first show post-lockdown, so it feels very, very special. We're going to start with a little lullaby called Lights and Shadows, which I chose particularly because the theme of this whole concert is really about photography, which uses a lot of lights and shadows. Yep, everybody. The next piece we're going to play is called Homecoming, and this is a piano trio I wrote a few years ago for Solstice Trio, and it was premiered in this room. and it was such a joy to compose for them. And one of the things I've really enjoyed about coming across from jazz into classical is when you can write a work for somebody else to play, and that wonderful, thrilling feeling of sitting in the audience, hearing musicians bring your work to life, and you just get to sit back and relax. It's it's really a huge honour and very thrilling. But however, it's also thrilling to have the chance to play the works that I'm playing tonight with myself on piano, and sort of bringing them to life how I imagined them in my head when I was composing them. So I am about to introduce Kyla Matsura Miller on violin and Paul Zabruani on cello to join me. So please give them a round of applause when they come through the door. While they get settled, I will just briefly tell you this piece is called Homecoming. It's a little bit inspired by Beyoncé's documentary called Homecoming, but mainly it's about feeling appreciation for living in a city that is making really great efforts to celebrate the achievements and creativity of women, and the Merlyn Myer is a great example of that. And also I wrote this at a time when Tempo Rubato was just opening up, which was a venue in Brunswick, and it's run by two incredible women. And so it was sort of reflecting upon how lucky I am to live in a place where the things that I do are able to be celebrated. So I thought I should say that because this is the Merlyn Myer Commission night. So, yeah, homecoming.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. It's such a privilege to play something for the very first time to an audience like this, in a space like this, with musicians like this. I really feel so incredibly privileged and grateful. I'd like to thank the Arundhay and Yul Gilbar Foundations for making the commission possible. And in this year of all years, it gave me something to hold on to keep composing during lockdown. It was so special. So I can't thank you enough. And I'd also really like to thank Julia Margaret Cameron. Her images, I can't remember where I encountered them. I think it was on the internet somewhere. But I was just immediately struck by the aesthetic of her work and how I felt that it could connect to mine. And I hope you all felt that too. I would like to introduce this incredible ensemble on stage with me. We have Melissa Dakey on flute. And Ben Opie on oboe and cor anglais. And Paul Zabruani on cello. And Katie Yap on viola. And Kyla Matsura-Miller on violin. And just by the way, Kyla is currently a Friedman finalist, which is happening this week. So wish her all the best. Very special. I would also, while we're here, really like to thank them, and also thank the Recital Centre, Marshall, all of the techs that have been involved in this. It's been so luxurious. We've been rehearsing in here for days. So special. And we've got to know lots of really amazing people. So thank you to everyone. We're going to finish with a tune called Into the Light. Sorry, I want to say tune. That's like a jazz thing. We're going to finish with a work called Into the Light. And this is actually the very first chamber music piece I ever wrote. So my background is as a jazz pianist and composer, and I was always writing stuff for myself to play, and I still do, obviously. And then I was commissioned by Plexus Ensemble to write a piece for International Women's Day when they were doing a concert in here. I think it was in 2015. And I said yes, and then was immediately struck with the crippling self-doubt of only ever having written really a jazz lead sheet, which is like a one page of music that you just go around and play. And all of a sudden I had to write a 7-minute chamber music work, and it was incredibly intimidating, and I nearly cancelled many times, but nevertheless I persisted. And the experience of sitting in here and hearing it performed in the salon really just instilled a new mission for me to become a composer in my own right. So I really owe it to this work and that opportunity with Plexus to where things are today. So in that spirit, I thought we would finish with this piece. It was dedicated to the nurses of World War I, who often had, dare I say it, pretty boring lives before World War I. I'm sure they loved being mothers and wives and stuff, but the opportunity to get on a boat and go to the other side of the world to contribute to World War I as a nurse must have been so exciting for some of them. And so this is called Into the Light because they're stepping into a light of a world they never really imagined before. It must have been pretty cool. So hope you enjoy. Thank you so much again. Thank you. thank you so much. You've been such a lovely audience, and that was a thrill to play. And I've never read so much notation in my life. So in the spirit of that, I'm going to put it away now. I'm going to play a piece from Hope. So Hope is an album that came out earlier this year on ABC Classic. And it's an album that I wrote. It started with the bushfires and then it ended with the second lockdown in Melbourne. And it was meant to inspire hope, but really, I mean, I hope it still does. But as I call it more an abbreviation of hopefulness and hopelessness. And it sort of explores that space that you often sit between where, depending on the day or what's going on, you might be on that spectrum on one side or the other. It's sort of trying to acknowledge the struggle as well as be hopeful. And I was really thrilled that this album was nominated for Best Classical Album of the Arias. thank you. And that's, for me, a huge special acknowledgement because I'm slowly moving into this genre. It's really validating to receive that nomination, and tomorrow morning my sister and I are going to the Arias, so that's pretty cool. In Sydney, we get to fly to Sydney. What an amazing concept. So I thought I'd play a piece from Hope for you. This is called The End of the Decade, and I wrote it on New Year's Eve or New Year's Day, I can't remember, but at the turn of the decade, reflecting upon the decade that had passed and, ominously, strangely, the decade that was to come. Thank you. I was going to walk off and come back. I'm still learning the bow thing, but I think I was supposed to come walk off and then come back on to bow a second time, but I forgot. Sorry. I forgot to acknowledge a very important person, actually. The photographs you've seen on the back wall through the performance that weren't the Julie Margaret Cameron ones, they were done by a contemporary regional Victorian photographer called Susie Blake. And we sort of realised that she would be a lovely photographer to take photos of us, and then when I called her, it actually turns out that she's a Julia Margaret Cameron specialist, and she actually does some lectures at a photography school about her portrait photography style. So it was an incredibly special marrying of people that are into Julia Margaret Cameron in one project. So, yes, a huge round of applause for Susie Blake as well. Thank you.